Hello and welcome back to Empyrion Galactic Survival. My name is Spanj. Welcome back to this Polaris Sanctuary POI that I got myself stranded in at the end of last episode. Oh yes. Yeah, these things happen. Okay, so I need to get out of here. There are big guns on the side of the walls in this place that will shoot me as soon as I leave this door. This guy is definitely not happy. He misses his family. You know, I've shot him. He doesn't want to die. He doesn't want to die. He wants to see his family again. But I'm a bastard! Ah, okay. Actually, do you know what? Because of the ballsiness of you getting in my face, I will let you live. Ballsy guy. Anyway, I think I killed the guys out here that were going to shoot me. I just need to run. I need to run back to my ship, which is all the way over there. Because we managed to succeed in the mission and kill the traitors. There's one there. I no longer need this POI. We completed the Xerox missions. We're honored with the Xerox. We're going to go and pay homage to our Xerox overlords now. Oh, God. There's a laser shot. Okay, hug the wall, hug the wall, hug the wall. All right. We're at the north exit. Fucking guns are looking at me already. I've gone the wrong way. Wait, what? Really? That's the way I need to go. Yep. Okay, I've gone the right way. Ooh, dear. Right. Run along the walls as best we can. There's probably going to be more droid things here. Let's reload our little plasma blaster, which is the single best weapon in the game for one-shotting these smug gits here. Run, run, run. Little strafing run across there. Get another kill. Hello. Hi. Hello. Hello. How are you doing? What are you doing over there, you little git? He's dead. All right. We got one health pod. This is where it gets all goes a bit wrong. I don't have anything on me like a motorbike or anything like that. Or any kind of little spawnables. It's a very good idea to always have a little SV ready to spawn in. I don't. I could probably get one in. I think I have enough resources in my factory that I could spawn a pretty decent SV in. No way of powering it. So we're just going to have to run, I'm afraid. Sorry, Mr. Little Bug Dude there. That was a bit overkill, wasn't it? That gun is going to shoot us. The other one on the wall is going to shoot us. But we're going to do our best to use the trees, use the rocks, use the terrain, use this small wreckage. Oh, God. Oh, God. We're taking shots. Taking shots from every direction now. Okay. Whew. Made it to the small wreckage. Heal up. There is definitely another dude out there shooting lasers at me. I don't know where he is. But I can hear him, though. Let's keep going. Okay, keep moving east. I think we made it, guys. I think we are out of... No, we're not! That's laser shots. Get in the low ground. Get in the low ground. Jesus. Christ. Okay, I need to go that way, northeast. Northeast is where the direction I need to go. Let's stop wasting valuable plasma bombs or whatever you call them on useless spiders. Yeah. Well, it's been a while since I've been out in the wilderness like this. Look, that's the first time I've seen a stegosaurus. For a while. Bloody stegosaurus, what are you doing in the game? Get a new mod for Elyon. Seriously, that steggy needs to be replaced a long time ago. Anyway, moving on. We're nearly at our ship now. So what we're going to do today, now that we've escaped that little POI on foot, that was fun. We're going to go and pay the Xerox a visit. We're not going to go attack them, but there are a few POIs I'm hoping that are in Xerox territory. More than any other territory I've been through, because obviously I've been through Polaris territory now. I've been through the Brotherhood, the Pirates, the Creel. We haven't visited the Tesh yet. We're not quite ready to do that. I need to finish a ship. I haven't quite finished yet. Taking a lot longer than I anticipated to get that thing ready. But once it's ready, we'll be able to go and pay the Tesh a visit. I just fear if I go and visit the Tesh in the Leviathan here, I will end up losing the Leviathan. Oh, crikey. What is that? Okay, I think that's my ship shooting in my general direction. Maybe. Oh, isn't it? Is that a Talon Warrior? Hang on, hang on, hang on. Is this guy seriously shooting crossbows at me? Yeah, alright. Take laser death. You simpleton. Anyway. Yeah, there's a couple of POIs I want to... Why is my stamina not regenerating? Wow, does it not regenerate if I'm moving? In heavy armor, baby. I love that heavy armor. It's possible because I'm hungry. There we go. In order to build the ship that I want to build... keep getting distracted, sorry. I need a lot of Xeno. So, you might be wondering, well, what the hell do you do with all the Xeno blocks that you get from POI loot? You probably looted several hundred by the time you've even got a CV. Well, if you continue to collect those Xeno blocks, you can bring in a capital vessel or a base that is actually built using Xeno blocks. Look at this magnificent beast. And that's what I'm going to do. The ship I'm building is actually partially, at least, made from Xenosteel blocks. Have a look at it. Fire it up. It's not ready yet. It's still in work in progress, but we can see at least the cost. Look how close we are to this thing already. A bit of pentaxid is what we need. Xeno, look, we're already at 2586 Xeno. We've got it already. I was really worried that we'd have to go and find some Xeno, some more Xeno. But generally, you pick up a bucket ton of Xeno just doing POIs and stuff. They just hang out in the loot containers all the time. We're going to need a bit more restroom zirconium, but that's fine. We know how to go and get that. I want to show you guys how to get a bucket load of Xeno, even though I don't quite need it yet for the new CV. Still, I think it will be relevant and hopefully useful. We're back in the ship. Okay, let's get prepped and ready to go. Have a quick look at the old map here. Territories. We are going to go into Xerax territory here. And because we're honored with them, you know, we'd just be able to waltz in and have a little look around and not have to worry about those zucking great Tavira class dreadnoughts wandering around. The only thing I need to worry about is anything that is of one of these houses. Rados, Gist, Abyssal, Xenu, Epsilon is the other one. I can't remember what the other one is. But Serdu, I think it is. It's Serdu. Yeah, Serdu. Because despite being honored with the entire empire, we're still unfriendly with the individual houses, which is kind of annoying, but there we go. If we can find, what we're looking for is abandoned POIs. Let me see if we can find an abandoned POI. Now there are there's usually an abandoned on the starter planet somewhere. I haven't scouted this place very much since we had to restart. But the one on the starter planet is probably going to be very small, probably won't do it. What we're going to be looking for is a much bigger abandoned POI, something like the abandoned bunker or something like that. We're going to have a little look around for one of those. Okay, so all thrusters engaged, power saves on, we're going to charge our shields because we are going into space. So let's go and have a look around, see if we can find ourselves a nice abandoned POI to farm. Oh, this is freaky. I am not used to this. I am chilling next to a Camerit class battlecruiser. Look at this magnificent beast. Oh, collision. Look at that. I gotta be careful because anything that says Rad or Gist or anything like that in the prefix, then I can't really go near. It's gonna shoot at me. And I suspect if I shoot back, I'm going to instantly lose rep with the Xerax Empire by shooting at one of their sub-factions. Still, that's pretty sweet, isn't it? We can absolutely just chill out with Xeraxian scumbags. It's never happened before. Level 3 orbital production. I wonder if they've got any traders on board. Station services. Ooh. Collision alert. Sorry about that. I'll buff out. It'll be fine. It'll buff out. oh dear. Right. Let's get an EVA boost on. Actually, get medium armor on, and then we're not actually burning like huge amounts of fuel, food, and stuff. Okay, let's go and have a look, see what this station's got, if anything. Orbital production. This looks a lot like the shipyard. In many, many ways. We have a bit of light, please. Got these gantries. Hello. It's as if this place is not designed for visitors, but for attackers. This is the thing with being friends with the Zraxians. All their POI is obviously designed to be conquered, not really traded with. Turn the game up on its head. Sup, bros? This is freaky. This is definitely freaky. Is that the core down there? Oh no, that's just the turret. That's it, that's the entire station. Wow. Kind of boring, huh? That is literally it. Just two floors. No traders. Nada. Exciting times to be friends with the Xerox. Well, there we go, there's one. I think this is a very, very old POI, in fairness. Probably needs some updating like many of them do. Typically, whenever I try and show off things like this, I always get the oldest POIs spawning in for me. Unless I spend hours and hours and hours trawling through sector after sector after sector trying to find the right POIs. As Son's Law would have it, was Murphy's Law as you might know it, I'll get the crappy old ones while you guys get all the nice new shiny ones. And there we go. Right, so, hello, Tavira Clash Dreadnought! Whoa! Collision alert! See, it's not just me that crashes into space stations then. That's okay. It's your own Taviras that do it. Look at that bloody thing. Oh my god. Joanne, coming across a Tavira sends the same sort of fear in me as coming across a Leviathan in Subnautica. You just see one of these majestic monsters come up to you and instant dread feels, holy crap, that's a lot of lag. Wow. Instant dread just sort of fills you up. Those things are evil. You're evil. They exceed CPU by several million, I think, just because of the sheer number of guns they've got. Again, it's something that's quite difficult to show without getting in a jetpack and having a little look around. I suppose I might be able to jump into an SV and have a little look around. These are the sort of things, unless you are honored with the Xerox, you want to definitely avoid. There you go, there's a little jiggly, kind of laggy look at the number of guns this thing's got. See all the rounded turrets on the wings there. Oh, it's so rubber bandy. I mean, single player here. Yeah, this sort of stuff on a server. I didn't expect to see it so much on a single player, but there we go. Absolutely covered in guns. Just absolutely covered in them. This is a very heavy militarized sector of space. Coming up to a Xerox shipyard as well. Another really old Xerox POI. It's cool though. It's cool. The only other time we of course see the sort of Tavira this close up is if we spawn it into creative mode and have a little look around. It is a big old boat, I tell you. Big old boat. Yeah, my little Leviathan here wouldn't stand a chance. You just can't hold up against magnitude of that firepower. It really can't. Okay, moving on then. Okay, there's the Xerox. Had a little look at some of their stuff without having to get shot back. We're still on the hunt for something abandoned that we can pillage. So let's continue looking. I think we'll start with things like snow planets and stuff, which I've already checked out the one here. There's no abandoned anything on it. So I'm starting to wonder if maybe Xerox territory is not the way to go and abandoned stuff might actually be outside of territory. So I'm going to have a little look around some more planets, see if I can find anything abandoned, and then come back to you guys if I find something. Oh, you look familiar. Perfect! Abandoned factory. That is exactly the sort of thing we're looking for. Bingo. I was hoping for a new one, maybe one we hadn't found before or done before, but the abandoned factory will do very nicely. Let's maybe turn pilot mode off because it's screwing with my landing cycle. Right. Yeah, my guns don't seem to like it very much. That is because the abandoned factory has got turrets within it. Now, these things, if left unchecked, will just go ahead and blast their way through the entire place in order to get to those turrets. So we're just going to turn them off of basis for now. I'm going to try and maneuver Leviathan as close as possible to this thing so that I can use the logistics, of course. I've run these plenty of times before. You'll hopefully maybe be familiar with it. Still, those of you that perhaps are not, it's a very, very useful POI to get on farm, basically, where you can just do it over and over again and benefit from all the resources within. I'm actually going to pack a radiation boost this time because that's going to be useful. Can get a bit radioactive in there. Weapons-wise, I think I'm good. We have the blaster, shotgun shells for days. Yeah, I think we're okay. Got a heavy armor back on, so we're going to burn through some food. But we are going to benefit from it, from all of juicy resources. Now, for the purposes of my ship, the next episode of this Let's Play, I'm going to need to get my restroom and symposium. But we've already been over that, so we're here to see how we get large amounts of Xenosteel blocks. I don't think I've got any on me at all at the moment, but as we saw earlier, I've got plenty in the factory. And you can get them from loot. You can get them from loot containers. This factory will probably have some loot containers that have some Xenosteel block. Gonna have some fun today. We're gonna use the Gatling turret, minigun. Oh, and it's a level one as well. This is just gonna be a slaughter. Right, these sorts of guys. Let's have our salvage box set up. Oh, the noises. I'm gonna worry about looting the small boxes on camera. I'll do that later. For now, we want the main loot boxes. They're the ones that will have Xeno blocks in them. What keeps opening and closing? I assume it's that thing there. I don't think there's any other box down here. Just the little ones, yeah. Just the cargo containers. Oh, the noises. there are several ways through. We can go through the vents down there. There is actually a loot crate just down here, right there. There it is. Bingo. And there is a way through this POI where you can run it extremely quickly. So, actually did a little challenge, speedrun challenge on my channel a while ago now of this exact POI, and there were guys managed to do this thing in under a minute. That's the ridiculousness of it. I heard something. But if you go through the door like this, you can expect lots of nasties to spawn and chase you, try to kill you. This being a level one, it's more like target practice for me at this point. It's fun. I'm enjoying it. That is a lot of them. Woo! All right, cool. That's a lot of them. That was where all that screaming was coming from, huh? Alright, good to know. And this is what we're after here. This stuff. Half the building is built from it. Okay. Ah, there we go. Double switch. I saw ya. Where are ya? Yeah, mum. You know what? I've missed the minigun. The problem with the minigun is it only really works with these level 1 mobs that I'm encountering. Anything more than that, and we'd struggle, I suspect. Right, this is where things get rather dicey. Yep, I thought so. Okay, so this is the turret control area. Let me just see, actually. Have I got any more medicines? I do not. Wow. Really? Holy crap. I mean, I got these kits and stuff, but no med pods. Buzzard, have you got anything? Oh, you got a lot of spoiled crap. I forgot to empty you, clearly. Okay. Give it up? No? Okay. Don't mind. Just checking everything now. In case I just left some meds somewhere. In a silly place. Clearly not. Oh dear. Oh wow. Okay, this might be different then. Bridge out. We've got we've got meds for days, but not the health pods. Still. It's gonna be helpful. Right. What we need to do in here is get to the switch, the turn off switch, as quickly as possible. Those things are gonna shoot us, which is gonna hurt. Come on. Ouch. That really hurts. Oh, hello, boys. Can I just heal for a second? Can you leave me alone for just a minute? That'd be great. Thanks. Oh, I took a lot of hits then. They were on form, those turrets. Sometimes they take a little while to realize that you're there, so they don't necessarily switch on for like a few seconds, and that gives you enough time to get to the switch. Here they come. Jai, the laser minigun's back. So, it's back. Brilliant. It does help that this is level 1, of course. It'd take a lot more laser shots if it was anything else. Right, we're not going to run the shortcuts. We can go through there and we can get into the last chamber very quickly, but I'll take my time. We are going to go and take every loot crate that we can find. And some of these will be Xenosteel blocks, I'm sure of it. There's a lot of loot crates in this one. All basic stuff. Now, there are loot behind here, but I think we need to core the place before we can get back there. Because, oh, look at that. We can get in here anyway. Ha ha ha. Plasma rifle. Oh, delicious. That will take. I've been missing the plasma rifle. That leaves for my collection just the epic plasma cannon. Because I think we got an epic rocket launcher. We did. We definitely got an epic rocket launcher. If we can get a plasma cannon, we will be complete. We still haven't got an epic armor, actually. Fairness. Still looking for that. Hi. Any more? Just a few. Yeah. Burn, baby, burn. There is so much loot in this place. Look at all this Xenosteel there. This is what you want. See, once we've cored this place, put our own core in it. It's a bit of a slog, but we'll be dismantling this place. And all the Xeno blocks we're going to get are going to be amazing. Right, there's another crap. Did not expect them to come through the doors quite so quickly. There we go. There's another turret through here. I think for this one, we just have to run past it. Oh, I don't think it's one of these blocks. I think it's one of the other ones. Okay, we just have to run out. Yeah, I know. Ouch. Yep. Okay. Enough of that. I haven't got any C4 on me. Blow it up. There's a red container up there as well. We have to remember to come back for that. That's funny. There is a floor, one of the floor panels back there in that room of the turret. It does go through to the next level down. But I cannot remember which one it is. Not while I'm under fire from a great turret like that. Yes. You cheeky bastards! Trying to drop me down, I see, huh? This is fun. Oh, some health. I do like it. The minigun just mowing everything down. It's joy, ladies and gentlemen. It's utter joy. Here we go. This is why I took a rad boost. 9 rads. We're getting 9 rads on this stuff. Okay. Death. Okay, this is going to be interesting because this is where there are a zillion and one scorpions. Alright, any more? That's where you fall through, you see? Through into all those scorps. And all those scorps. Yeah. Oh dear. Level 1 abandoned factory with an epic minigun. It's good. Do you see their arms clipping through the walls? Marvelous. Now, if you're quite finished. Gotcha. We could go through there. There are enemies through there, but that is not the way we go. We go through here. And grab that. Giant surprise, we haven't had any Xeno blocks yet in any of these loot crates. The bug that always gets stuck in the vent. It's been there for so long. Right, okay, might actually switch to the plasma blaster for this, because as we go in here, okay, there it is. Ah, music to my ears. Yes. Wonderful. Anyway. There we go. One core cord. And for our troubles, some zascosium, lovely. Some pentaxid and zascosium as well. Still, no Xenosteel blocks. I mean, it's no big deal. I'm just, again, the game is making me out to be a liar. But I mean, you know, we've had Xenosteel blocks out of loop before, so it's just this particular instance that's decided to not prove that particular point during the video, which is typical. Clear out the last of these little buggers. And there we go. That is it. That is the abandoned factory. Very fun at level one with an epic video, I gotta say. Quite easy. Very easy, in fact. But enjoyable. Nice, relaxing run. Okay, so now what I gotta do is I gotta get my own core. I'm gonna slap it into this place. And then with the retrieve block settings here on this multi tool, we're gonna see how many. Oh, you are alive. Yeah, you were alive. We're going to see how many Xenosteel blocks we actually get from this place. In fact, if we have a look at the CPU statistics page, we can see how many blocks are in here. I think that's 161,000. That's how much CPU costs for 2,886 blocks. So, assuming we get them all, we will have 2,886 Xenosteel blocks by the time we finish with this. Just a case of going around and finding them all. Now, a lot of them are going to be buried in walls and things like that, but generally I find once you've found sort of a little patch of them, there you go, we're getting the whole blocks back. It's going to take a while and it's going to be particularly boring, but we will get our Xeno material from this, and by building your ships using Xenosteel blocks, these things have more hit points than combat steel and weigh less, so they're definitely worth it. The only problem with these things is the textures suck. Generally what I do is I fill the armor with Xenosteel, and then the inside and outside blocks are regular kind of hardened steel, combat steel, whatever. And that is how you can really benefit from the lightweight armor of these blocks. But the only way to get them is to do this. You can't mine deposits to do them. You have to dig them out of POIs, particularly POIs like the abandoned factory here. It's another bit of labor of love, really. And there we go. That's about 2,800 and something or other. 2,824 Xenosteel blocks there. That we dug out along with collapsing a bunch of other stuff. And that'll do it. That'll do it. So we could now put that in the factory and we can get our Xenosteel combat ship producing. Now, like I said at the beginning of this episode, it ain't ready yet. But we have the resources. I just need to go and get a little bit. Why is this taking so long? I need to go and get a little bit more restrooms as a cozy and bloody hell game. Seriously, can you maybe load the blueprint library? Holy crap. I think there might be something wrong with Steam right now. Okay. Well, anyway, from what I remember, we needed some restrooms as a cozy. So we're going to go and do that next. I'll do that off camera because we've seen that before. We just need to find something like a lava planet. There's a lava moon there that doesn't have anything on it, unfortunately. Nascent moon would be good. There you go, look, the restroom is a cozium. There's a nascent moon, there's Xerox about, but we're friendly with them, so that shouldn't be a problem. Okay, so my restroom is a cozium, and then hopefully the Steam Workshop will be working by the next episode, and we can get in our new ship that we're going to use to take care of the Tesh over here. We haven't seen these guys yet, so it's going to be interesting to see what they're all about. Like I said before, I don't think they have a lot of stuff yet. They have a few ships and that's about it. But yeah, in the meantime, I've got a bit of a journey ahead of me as well. I think I've got the pentaxid to do it. So I'll see you over here in the next episode. That's going to be all for today. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And hopefully, I'll see you next time. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.